Hey guys, welcome to my garden. Let's do an early morning harvest. So today I've decided to harvest a lot of Swiss chard. This year I've planted a lot of Swiss chard in my greenhouse. So the only thing or the best that you can do to promote or to keep your Swiss chard flourishing in your garden is to simply keep on harvesting it, trim it. Whenever you see some old leaves on your Swiss chard, remove them. That will prevent the spread of diseases. And it will also save a lot of energy for your Swiss chard to keep on thriving and flourishing. Swiss chard is one of the iron-rich vegetables that you can grow in your garden. So I love Swiss chard, and the fact that you can grow Swiss chard throughout the year, it's amazing. So another thing, an early morning harvest is also advised to prevent shock to the Swiss chard plants. And always make sure that you water your garden only in early hours, like in every morning and also in the evening. So growing food is my passion. So since this year I grew more than what I can simply consume, sharing is caring, you know. So let's go, let's start our harvesting. I drink water the garden today early in the morning. You know how winters are. I just love winter. Most of the veggies that I grow in my garden, they are winter crops, so they seem to be flourishing a lot in winter. Swiss chard is very, very much easy to grow because there are some few challenges when it comes to growing Swiss chard. Normally, we have very few diseases that can affect your Swiss chard. And another thing, what I've noticed about Swiss chard, you don't have to keep the leaves for a long period of time. Like, for example, cabbages, whenever you're growing cabbages, the challenges are seems to be a lot, like, to deal with. And we have different diseases and different worms that are normally after cabbages. So for me, Swiss chard, I have no excuse for not growing Swiss chard. I just love how everything is green and healthy. The leaves, they seem so healthy and flourishing during the winter months. So if there is one of the crops out there that I will never stop growing, Swiss chard has to be one of them. And the benefits, the health benefits in Swiss chard, they are amazing, guys. I have already made some few videos in the past about Swiss chard. And another thing, Swiss chard is also a nitrogen fixer. So if you want to keep your garden healthy, make sure that you also grow some nitrogen fixers there and there. Nitrogen fixers such as the Swiss chard, spinach, and peas. Peas and Swiss chard are my favorite. So that's why during the cold seasons, I grow them. If you're going to use this way of growing Swiss chard, like the overcrowding way, you'll have to make sure that you Water you see your switchyard beds very often. Remember, this switchyard is no longer in the seedling stage. You can tell it's very huge now, and it consumes a lot of water. That's why these switchyard beds, they are almost dry all the time. As for the watering routine, it will depend on where you stay. I recommend that whenever the temperatures are very high, water your garden in the morning and also in the evening. Just check if the soil is dry or not. That's what I usually recommend. I don't just simply say water twice per week or three times per week because it depends on where you stay. I don't want you to ruin your crops, and I don't want your crops to become dehydrated and start withering and then start drying out. Simply check the soil always. Well, in my case, since it's winter, I did water my garden in the evening yesterday. Last night, I did water my garden. And I'm not gonna water it in the morning today. I'm going to water it again in the evening. I will check first if it's dry. Because overwatering can also cause damage than good. So we'll have to water it again if the temperatures are going to be very high. Yes, it's winter, and the temperatures can also rise throughout the day. So far, that's a lot of Swiss chat. Anyway, guys, thanks a lot for watching. Please like, share, and subscribe. Feel free to leave a comment.